My name is Joe Rowe. I've been a game designer for probably more than 10 years, best part of 10 years. I've worked in educational content and more recently in entertainment. My job as a games designer is mostly programming, but I also work in art and user interfaces, such as in-game menus or sprite animations or even 3D animation work. Graphics is a really broad term, but typically with games, because they're so media rich or there's so much content inside them, you could use graphics to describe how somebody is getting feedback from the game. So in your user interface or in your menu system, how do you start a game? By clicking on a button, which would be graphically drawn, or more importantly, actually in the game, where you have possibly 3D animated characters that are talking to you as a player, or 2D sprites in a simple game like Flappy Bird. Every single character, every single thing that you see inside a game or even in any animated content will be made of very simple basic shapes. It just, how many basic shapes. So what we're talking about is geometry. So all of you who are ignoring your geometry lessons in your maths class, it's time to pay attention if you really want to get into games, simply because everything that you see inside a game is either made of a quad or a polygon or a square or a triangle. And then we use groups of those triangles or quads or squares to actually make up more complex shapes or meshes, as we call them. Well, you have to love it. And I don't mean just love playing games. You have to also have enough passion and drive to stick with the actual game creation process, because believe it or not, it is very, very hard work. You have to have a good understanding of time management. You have to have a good understanding of how to break down more complex work into smaller parts that you can achieve tackle on a daily and weekly basis. It helps to have a good understanding of one of the key components of a game, be it art or maths and programming or even storytelling. So I have two jobs as a game designer. I love making games, particularly artificial intelligence. I love when something comes alive in my game and challenges me as much as I challenge it. And then as a teacher, where I teach games here in Pulse College, I love when somebody figures out something based on what I've taught them, but comes up with something new and something different, something that I've never even come across myself or something unexpected. And in that, it's almost like an evolution or a next step. And it gives me kind of an insight as to where maybe the games industry will go next with this new crop of students.